Good morning, students. Let us commence today's session. So in the last session, we have discussed the different types of services provided by different CSPs, as well as based upon our SQL platform, what are all the major CSPs are providing, especially from Microsoft, Amazon, and Google. We have seen varieties of services, as well as we have seen characteristics and benefits of SOA. In that specifically, we have talked about how loosely coupled this environment is, right? So some major things that we have covered in the session. In today's session, we are going to see something interesting that related to this, what could be the first research paper they wrote? That's also one of the key component of discussion today. Continuing with that, we have one more research paper to discuss also related to this today's topic, how people are comparing SOA with the object-oriented architecture and resource-oriented architecture, how people are comparing, what are all the parameters that they have taken into consideration for comparing these architectures, what are all the technology support, these are all theoretical aspects, right? What are all the technology support, that means in practical cases, how are those things are available? All those things that we are going to discuss in today's session. So before getting into the today's session in deeper section, that we will have a recap that what we have seen in the previous session in terms of an MCQ. And I suggest the students, please you revise what we have conveyed in the previous session at the end of your class hours, okay? So that will be more useful for you to answer these types of questions. Most of these questions are being retrieved from your campus papers, as well as from the branded websites that are supplying MCQs, as well as the websites which are preparing, especially for company interviews. From those only the questions are being taken. So it's good to answer these questions and explore your content apart from the subject also, because the subject SOA and the cloud computing will not fetch you the knowledge only from textbooks and lectures. How much practical that you are going to yield the knowledge, that's the only thing which will give you a key role in this, because these two subjects are mandatory for everyone, even though if you are in any field, okay, any domain, right, any structure that where you are working. So that's the reason why I am insisting on this. And regarding one more thing, I want to convey that we have launched the assignment by last Saturday itself, and it's good to see around some minimum number of students have submitted, and we have corrected and written it also. We request all the students to complete the assignments probably by the end of this week, so do not carry it forward, and follow the protocol as it is, right? So getting into today's session, what's the answer for this MCQ? Because today's questions are being derived from services, so you must know these service, right? If I'm using Amazon Pay, or if you are using Google Pay, if I'm using Phone Pay, right? So I need to know what is the back end of the service. So what back end of my application, what's the service that you are using? That is the billing and account management service from the Amazon environment. Yes, need answers in your chat box. Type 1, 2, 3, 4, any one option. No options till now. So have your question again. So you have to explore knowledge on this. It could be like what you call in lower standards, how you will move forward, like your GK, the same way only here. Options please. Yes, we have some options. Yes, people have found out, huh? Support of technology is there for you. That's the reason why you are ready to convey the answers correctly. So Amazon Development Pay Framework, actually it is. That's what Amazon Dev Pay. That's a billing and account management service. It's like a template, right? Anyone that they want to create a payment module, I won't say payment gateway, payment module, they'll be using this service, right? I could able to customize anything, right? So when we are going to pay for our railway reservation ticket, you could able to see all the options, debit card, credit card, UPI, right? You could able to see some sort of built-in wallets, right? All those types of entries are available, right? I could able to customize and pay for this, and it will ready to create. And the best part of this DevPay is it is having the built-in component of dual signature, right? Dual signature is the basic concept behind our mechanism of identifying our vendor. This triple triangle, they'll convey like this, the triangle point, the vendor, customer, and the bank, right? Second question. DaaS is the central application in the AWS portfolio, right? Central application. That means all the Amazon Web Services are available on this platform. That's what their question is. You have to identify the platform. Which could be the platform? I think it's very easy to find out. Yes, answers. Yes, people started generating answers. Answers are coming as two. Good, because first one and third one are services. Okay, so fourth one ultimately it won't come. Second one is the platform actually. So whatever the service that we are ready to access and use it for our programming environment or use it for our infrastructure or otherwise that what we are going to use it for our another services or ready to use for any tailored application, everything will be available on this Elastic Compute Cloud only, EC2. That's the famous framework or the platform where all the services are being available. Even if you can, even you can create your own web service and launch on this Amazon EC2. I think AWS is giving $200 for initial stage usage. They are giving free $200. So you can write a web service in Java or .NET. You could able to launch it in the EC2. It's very easy. So how to access from the EC2? They will generate access key and a token. So when you get this access key and token, you can use it in your program and you could able to access and generate the output in your corresponding web page or web application, wherever you want to port that value, that you could able to do that. Right? So that much interesting it is. Third one. So it's a fundamental to test your knowledge. What you have learned. Completely test your fundas. Amazon Web Services falls into which of the following cloud computing category? So please understand and answer. So I think Dinakaran sir have given you a complete overview on this. Both the subject are related. Okay, so you have to relate and study SOA and CC. Platform as a service, software as a service, infrastructure as a service, backend as a service. So everything can be accessed as a service. Backend they are talking about database. Okay, so what could be the answer for third one? People supplying answers as one. Platform. More options are from platform. Yes, more options are from platform. I think there could be some misconception will be there. It's always infrastructure. Infrastructure will comprise of all these things. That's it. Okay, infrastructure will have all these things. See, whenever you are getting confused on these types of things, remember the block diagram of computer, right? Except input and output, everything will be available for us to access as a service. That's it, including hardware and software. The components of CPU, it's enough for us to work with a discless station even nowadays, right? So infrastructure will comprise everything. That's the idea here we want to suppose to have. That could be the main content. So please remember this always. Infrastructure will comprise everything, everything in terms of. Yes, this is a very famous question. How many buckets you can create in AWS? First, you must understand the content, right? What could be this bucket? What is mean by bucket actually? It's a cloud resource storage actually. Cloud resource storage. How many buckets can you create in AWS by default? People are searching for answers, I think so. Huh? So ultimately option is one, right? Default is 100 buckets. You could be able to see in your service logging, right? You could be able to create 100 buckets. So it is ready to store. It is ready to store your resources, whatever that you are consuming from the cloud. Okay. So after a stage that you need to purchase buckets also to store it. That's what everything. That's what the term infrastructure as a service. Whatever that you are going to do, you are going to pay. What are the different types of instances, right? What are the different types of instances? It relates mainly on infrastructure only, okay? It relates mainly on infrastructure only. So what are the different types of instances? It's common for all types of service providers. It's common for the SOA platform actually. Short answer, general purpose, computer optimized, storage optimized. Computer means a computational node, okay? Storage optimized, all of the above. What's the answer? So people have suggested all of the above. We have an option, right? Always to choose that flexible option in all the MCQs, that will give us very good mark, right? But please understand and provide for that, right? General purpose means I don't have any specifications. I need this much of RAM, I need this much of secondary storage space, and I need this much of CPU power to execute my program, right? All those things will be predefined. That's what general purpose, right? Computer optimized means I will concentrate only on, I think in you could be able to come across in grid computing, compute node and the data node, right? So data node is storage optimized, compute node is computer optimized. So that's the main thing. So I could be able to increase my computational capacity alone, right? And I could be able to increase my storage capacity alone. That's the thing. See, I think soon we are going to pay for our Google Drive also, I think so. Once the, I think we started using this Meet recordings, and we started using G drives. So likewise, our daily consumption of these spaces are increasing with or without our knowledge. So I think one day we will have a billing mechanism will come, okay, soon, because we can't able to erase the data, right? Otherwise, what we will do? We'll go and purchase some sort of hardware to store the any external USB source to store something. So at some case, we are in a stage, we are getting into an era where we are going to be billed for our data storage. Till now, we are paying for our data consumption, right? Now we will get into second era that we are going to pay for data storage soon. That's going to happen. How we are paying monthly subscription for our DTH and mobile postpaids, mobile postpaids and internet billing. So likewise, we will be ready to pay for our data soon, right? So that could be the stage that we will start with 2022. That's a projected year being hosted by DataQuest, a famous magazine which will talk about computer statistics, right? And commencing with the today's session, that we have an interesting paper on comparison of this SOA with other architectures, right? As well as it want to compare itself also. Author Benjamin and Ezra, they have given an interesting overview. You can search this paper and could have a detailed study. But here I am ready to give you that overview. What made a SOA to be very famous as well as to be very flexible, still it is playing in the market, still the projected usage of this SOA platform will be for next to 40 years. Okay, so that could be our complete environment. That's the reason why the first point we'll completely talk about what we have discussed yesterday. Again, loose coupling, platform independence, interoperability. See, apart from all these things and important stages, this interoperability, right? So this is the key factor. Microsoft have took its hand and it got worked out in most of the environment. But unfortunately, due to their proprietary services, they could not be able to launch in all the sections. That is the reason why still their cloud services are not famous. Okay, but AWS have reached a short span. That could be their major, I think. And as well as they are the first one, they are ready to build in a huge way. So that's also a major content on this interoperability, right? So language APIs are ready to support for us at any case. But the thing is, how it is reusable and interoperable for other services and other other applications, how much it is extensible. That's the main thing. And as well as second point is completely related to us, academia, right? But the academia industry that they have mentioned. See, when a product will get to be very famous, especially a service product, right? Service product, that's what even I will convey. Both of them are different, product-based company and service-based company. But here we are using anything as a service. So in that case, it could be a service product. So academic environment will need to explore on more services. In that, students will get to be trained and those services will be adapted as a platform in the industry. In that, students will the people who are placed will ready to go and work. That is the thing will make the market. This could be the cycle of complete employment as well as the way of driving the market industry. So that's the major role these web services are playing. You need to be trained on web services. That's what people are talking about there. So I am ready to work in a system which is having a standalone content. No, the trend has changed. You need to work on online only, right? You need to work, you know how to use a tool in the cloud environment, right? So that's what everyone is expecting. So that's what the people are talking about there. Okay. And I could able to identify where I could see faulty implementations, because it's like YouTube, whatever you want to take, that you can create a video and you could able to upload, right? So that's what the cases are happen nowadays. Even you could able to see some of the viral and trending contents are there in YouTube. So which is necessary and which is not necessary. So how to identify such those things? That's also an important case study with respect to SOA. How to filter unnecessary web services, how to filter necessary web services. That's a key challenge here. Even you could able to work on that, right? So further to continue with that paper, especially I think the previous regulation, people have studied a paper on software patents. Okay, so what about these patents? So every architecture have its own pattern. Even if you come for Java, it consists of 5 different patents. Okay, so when people are studying with Maven, Spring, Struts, so in those things, this pattern will give you a vital role. Okay, so components and connectors. Connectors are nothing but the like our JDBC and ODBC. The drivers will come into the picture. So components are nothing but it could be heterogeneous or homogeneous, whatever may be. So everything will be discussed over there in this paper. As well as what could be the uniqueness of this SOA, and SOA, I want to convey that, see, if your program or if an application running in the platform in a normal local desktop or in a LAN, it takes around 2 weeks or 3 weeks to complete, to execute that program, right, to see the result. But in the cloud, it is taking only less than a minute or less than 1 or 2 hours. Means that is not the actual strength of SOA, right? SOA's innate strength is measured by all the factors, not only computational capacity. That's also a major thing they want to stress in this aspect, right? So that's the important things that they have discussed. If you go through the paper, you could be able to understand further on this. Okay. See, this is what we need to move forward. So digitization age had completed. See how we are comparing. See, initially we have worked with without network. Without network. That's what tier one. See that microcontroller 8088. Okay. It's a coprocessor actually. Not only microcontroller, it's a coprocessor. So we have worked in that. So in the two tier, we have a server and a client. Server and client architecture. Still, we could able to digitization in age only. Web enabled. So using IP, using TCP IP, I have connected the different servers as well as I could able to talk about not only client server, even here I could able to talk about peer-to-peer computing. So when these models are compute, when these models are being combined, when internet is coming to picture, okay, after LAN, when internet is WAN, okay, this wide area network has emerged. What happened? The digitization age is have a transit from digitization to integration. Okay, so that's the place where most of the enterprises will come into the hub. So that's what being given. So apart from that, they have a hub to access the corresponding resources. That's what mentioned, corresponding resources, because a corporate don't have all the resources, okay, especially infrastructure related resources. So it need to lease, or it need to lend, or it will buy for it will buy and it will give maintenance to some other concern, right? So if you come for if you take our TNEB, right, so their entire billing and management services, node maintenance, everything has been given to Reliance. Reliance data center is taking care of complete Tamil Nadu electricity board services management software, completely, right? Their billing data, everything, they will take care of that. So such type of integration hubs have emerged. Okay, finally, when these things are being outsourced, what happened? People have come into the real picture of enterprise SOA, right? What is this enterprise SOA? That I could able to create my own clusters. That's it. I could able to create my own clusters, that you could be able to reuse and interoperate with my clusters also. So that's what the diagram is ready to focus on. By accessing that service, I could be able to work with my complete platform. For example, a very good example is I could be able to access my anywhere, anytime banking. That's an example for our enterprise SOA. Right, I could able to access, I could able to transfer to any bank. So that's a remarkable thing that SOA bring into our banking sector, banking and fintech sector. Nowadays, even for DMAT accounting, likewise, if you are in shareholding, if you are ready to purchase some shares or equity, so no need to make any separate transactions from your SB account, just to transfer the amount to DMAT account. Both are maintained by bank only, but related to stock and equities, that will be managed with the DMAT. Whenever you are going to get profit or loss, that is being managed with the DMAT account and your SB account only through these types of banking and stock equity centers. That's it. So they could be able to manage it through the same environment. That's what enterprise SOA, right? I could be able to do that. The second stage is what now people are exploring. Cross enterprise SOA. I could able to use it in a heterogeneous environments. So enterprise SOA is completely homogeneous, but cross enterprise SOA is completely heterogeneous. For example, Walmart have its complete infrastructure. You know about that. Walmart is a very famous retail outlet in the global arena. Okay. Target is the second major player. But the framework created by Walmart is used by Target. That is a major thing. Okay. So I think most of our multi-staged or supply chain management integrated environment of very big chain of bazaars, chain of bazaars, right? Reliance One, likewise, Big Bazaar, chain of bazaars are the models being derived from this cross enterprise SOA only, right? So I could able to take the entire framework, just I will rename, that's it. I could able to reuse it. I could able to customize it based upon my environment. That's possible. That's what cross enterprise SOA. So the complete platform can be reused. Right. And here I want to bring a concern here. What would be the overlap? Because I could able to find out some of the students have had a chat with me that what could be the overlap, because you are talking about cloud computing as well as you are talking about SOA. What could be the overlap? How could they able to differentiate, right? See, remember that SOA is the implementation platform for cloud computing. Okay, cloud computing is nothing but your application layer. That's it. SOA is the stack where the complete development is happening, right? So SOA is your stack. Nowadays you are talking about it, a full stack developer, right? So the development environment is your SOA, application layer, because from that only consumer is taking that service and using, right? Cloud computing is like a supermarket where SOA integrated web services are available, where you can go on to purchase it, right? That's what the role of cloud computing is. So you're able to see that cloud computing is a supermarket which will sell all the services. How these services are developed using SOA, that's it. That's the thing. In that, we have seen in the previous section here, enterprise SOA, I will get only the services from Amazon. I will get only the services from Google. I will get the services only from Amazon. But cross enterprise SOA is not like that. I will, in the same system, I could be able to use the services of all things, as well as the API which is available in one service could be able to reuse it for another API in the different service. That's a major criteria, right? So in the overlap, that's what they have mentioned. So only the application layer will let to differ that, as well as producer consumer model also will ready to change depending upon our enterprise, right? So that's the major thing. As well as I could able to experience very good service when cloud or IP wide area network support is being instantiated. That's a major idea. As well as cloud computing is completely an abstract one, right? It will not exhibit what's happening behind the screens, right? If it is a concept called scalability, I could not able to understand how my resources are increasing, but through web services I could able to monitor that. Through my SOA I could able to monitor, so how this application integration is happening, so how mature it is in handling the scalability, right? I could able to find it out in an easier way. That's the thing. To manage with the technology and protocols, we are concentrating on SOA. To manage my application level services, I am concentrating on cloud computing. That's the major idea. See, people who are developers will work in SOA. People who are working as executives, they will work on cloud computing. They are only users, right? See, I could be able to convey a clerk in the bank is a user already, right? So they have the Pinnacle is a famous software being used by all the banks across India, recognized by RBI. Okay, the Pinnacle is the complete service provided and managed by our Oracle. Okay, so they will take care of everything. So here clerk is also user only. When you are going to access your mobile banking in your device, so you are also user only, right? So the producer consumer model will play a vital role here. That's what I have conveyed while closing the SLA session. If you are going to construct a very good SOA model with less cost effective, that means it must be lightweight for the user, it must be lightweight for the corresponding corporate, as well as for developer, it could be a concern, very easy to leverage. So if you are going to keep this centroid of these all these 3 points, your SOA model will be a successful one. That's what even you could able to see. Even yesterday I have conveyed about a tech startup in IIT Madras. So likewise, so many people are ready to emerge to give a less cost effective SOEM model, right? So you could able to try for that. Even students who are approaching for final year project work, you could able to think about that. Why don't you design your best SOEM model to leverage the cost effective fashion, right? So that's what we have discussed has been tabulated here. Major attributes, how it is differentiating, granularity, right? So granularity means regarding how I am using the individual services. That's what granularity. So if I object and resources are purely based on the objects only, so I won't differentiate object and resources, but pertaining to service oriented, everything will be accessed as a service. That's what you are learning in your cloud, right? So main focus is on these three parameters only. On demand only in service we will use, right? Resource oriented means whenever I need, I will use that corresponding site address. That's all. So object oriented means I will communicate using the parameters. Addressing and the request routing. Okay. So main focus, the process of accessing the service, that is related with this request routing. That's all. Okay. So for every application, we have unique address in our resource oriented. So regarding object, just I have to go for I have to follow a protocol. That's what a simple example is, CORBA, common request, common object request, broker architecture, or IIOP, right? So these protocols will help me for object oriented environment, right? So for service oriented content, so I have a particular what do you call, if you want to say in a consumer aspect, an icon will be there. If I'm ready to click, it's ready to provide me the service. That's it. Okay. Or replies catchable, that's a major thing. Okay. Ultimately, your browsers having the variable or having a JavaScript object history that is ready to restore my services. But object and services are not applicable here, because objects cannot be stored in our cookie or in a history variable, because history and cookies also again objects only, right? You could not able to store that. Services are nothing but session based, so even I could not be able to store these things also. So catchable is applicable only for websites and web applications. So that is the major criteria. So application interface, surely they will differ, right? Resource oriented means I need some HTTP or HTTPS to access the contents. That means especially some web server I need to access. Okay, so pertaining to object oriented, I could have something called a specific protocol or a middleware. Example, EJB, I'm ready to access my business logic. But when we are going for service oriented, I need a yellow page. That's what yellow page is, nothing but UDDA, that is being comprised, and a service is written using WSDL, web service description language, right? It's enough for me to understand and move forward. So payload as well as data format description. So what could be the language that they are using? So they are using, for example, they are given IDL. So in the same language where you are using your driver, that could be specific. Pertaining to resource oriented, no need to worry about it, because HTTP or HTTPS, they will take care of post or get method. So we don't have any role on that. So regarding our service oriented architecture that we are going to work with, XML schema, because that will give me XML NS. Remember that we have studied in unit 1, XML namespace. So XML namespace will, it is enough to understand what does it have. That's what, that's a major comparison of these three types of architectures. Okay, so that's a interesting parameters. So if you want to measure, so I'll convey, you can take these 3 + 3 = 6 parameters. Okay, granularity, you can, instead of using the attribute main focus, you can use the term marshalling, how you are accessing the values, marshalling, addressing, catchable performance, application interface, payload. You can take these 6 parameters and try to measure not only OO and RO, right? Only for SOA, you can measure all those 3 different players, Google, AWS and Microsoft. If you measure all these 6 things, you could be able to find out who is playing in a major and a vital role in the corporate, that you could be able to find out, right? So these parameters will really assess. Even you can write your own research paper using these 6 papers. And you can, for example, by integrating machine learning, that you could be able to find out For example, a basic example, by employing a linear regression, you could able to focus which player will get more revenue by the next financial year, that you could able to predict using these six parameters, right? So that could be an interesting research paper you can write using this SOA. Yes, that's a thing that it is ready to classify. Object-oriented systems are completely closed only, right? So always they could have a communication between client and server is closed only because they will be mapped with the IP address and port number. So you could not be able to do anything more than that. Could be centralized only. Pertaining to resource, you must have some validity, right? So once the validity expires, you could not be able to use the resource. As well as validity, you have some maximum limit also. So you cannot be able to reconfigure that validity. That's the major drawback in resource-oriented approaches. But our SOA is completely flexible, right? So it's like you created something and you place it there. Whenever anyone need to use, just to pay end use. That's it. That's what the role of SOA, right? So if anybody need to understand what the service is going to do, a user manual will be there. If a programmer want to understand, you have a WSDL, right? If a developer want to understand, you have a WSDL of the corresponding service. WSDL is open source, right? So that you could be able to access and use it. No need of a, see, if I need to work with OOA and ROA, I need some APIs to work with, but here no need of any APIs, right? WSDL is enough to pass parameters as a programmer, right? As a user, no need of even WSDL. I need only that service name, HTTP localhost colon 8080 slash service name. That's all. Service is ready to run on my system. Okay. So that's the thing. So here, one of the famous SOA framework, that since I think online university curriculum is majorly concentrating on open source. That is the reason why I'm ready to concentrate on this example, right? So the SOA framework is nothing but, an example is Gini. Please browse about this Gini. That's a major one that you could be able to create a SOA platform using this, right? You write your Java web service and you could be able to store it in a server that you could be able to access whenever that you need, right? Even you could be able to manipulate those services. You can create your own UDDA. Whatever the value that you want to pass towards that UDDA, that through WSDL that you could able to pass, web service will help you on managing those complete environment, right? So especially one more advantage is when XML is going to combine with Java, the powerfulness of both of them will increase, right? It's like Gemini, two powers are being combined. So that's what Gini, that the name they have given actually, right? Not only the any conception based on Java, right? Java is being combined with that. That's the reason why it's termed as Gini. So role of XML is very, very important with respect to this Gini. Summarizing, so what we have seen on those things. So a repeatable business task is converted into a service nowadays. How this can be linked with the customer environment? How this task can be linked with the customer environment? That is what service orientation. Okay. What is service oriented architecture? How could I able to create a template? That's all. That's what SOA that we are going to work with. So how to do for a complete enterprise, what I have to do? So for that, I have to create a composite application. The application will ready to give me that. Even these composite applications are available ready-made in the clouds, right? If you want to start a software firm which is going to work only with some stock and other environment, stock and equity, you have a ready-made software to manage that. Just the thing is pay and access the website address of it. It's enough. You are ready to access and use the services. That's what the complete summary that what we have discussed over there. Okay, so to flow with this, we have this web services. And the bottom of the slide, you could be able to see BPEL4WS, right? So using this business process execution language for web service, you could be able to create web service using this BPEL. So It's a business process modeling language. So how you have studied your OOAD, right? You have a UML. Likewise, that is for object-oriented architecture. For our SOA, we have this BPEL 4WS. That's it. That's the main thing. So this is the UML for our SOA platform, for our web services, right? So that is the thing that I want to stretch here. By that, we will stop. If you have any clarifications, you can post it in the chat.